Is your organization currently struggling to track the different types of vendors you pay? Do you need the ability to segment your vendors in QuickBooks Online? In this tutorial, I am going to show you how to create vendor types in QuickBooks Online to track the different types of suppliers you pay without messing up your charts of accounts. Hey guys, this is Ufoma Ogaga from Goshen Bookkeeping and Consulting. One of the great features QuickBooks Desktop has is the ability to use the vendor type feature to segment the different types of contractors and suppliers that you pay on a regular basis. This feature does not exist in QuickBooks Online. To replicate the vendor feature in QuickBooks Online, we are going to be using a custom field. There is one caveat to all of this. As of the time I'm recording this video, custom fields for vendors only exist in QuickBooks Online Advanced subscription. Therefore, to do everything that I'm about to show you, you must be using QuickBooks Online Advanced subscription. If you are new to QuickBooks Online, use my partner link in the description box to save 50% off QuickBooks Online Advanced subscription for 1 year. If you are a 501c3 nonprofit organization that is currently using QuickBooks Online Plus Edition, you can visit techsoup.org to upgrade to QuickBooks Online Advanced Edition. See the link in the description box for more details. So in this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a custom field to track your vendor types in QuickBooks Online Advanced. And I'm going to show you how to apply the custom field to your vendors and demonstrate how the information appears on your expense forms and reports. To create a custom field, click the gear icon and select custom fields. Click create custom field if this is your first time creating a custom field. If not, just click whatever button appears on your screen. Click add field and select vendor info. The field name should be called vendor type. Select the drop-down list as the type. Add as many lines as you need and enter your drop-down options in the order you want. As of now, there is no easy way to rearrange the order of your drop-down options once you have entered them. So I recommend adding your options in the order you need them and also make the names generic to grow with your organization. Check the boxes next to use on PO and use on other expense forms. Once you're done with everything, click save and close. Here is a custom field that I created. Now let's apply the custom field to our vendors. Going to the vendor center, you will notice that there is not a batch action function to make it easier to apply the custom fields to multiple vendors at once. So I recommend applying the custom field to your service vendors first and come back later and apply the field to all of your other suppliers. In our vendor list here, click a vendor's name and select the edit button to open up their profile. Scroll down to add the custom field and click save. Repeat this process to add the custom field to all of your vendors. This process should probably take you no more than 30 minutes or less to complete. Now let's look at an expense form to see how the custom field is displayed. I am going to create a check by clicking on the plus new button and select check. Let's search for a vendor's name. You will see that the custom field appears here. This is a nice reminder when you are recording a transaction to remember that this is a service provider, so you put the expense in the right category. So I'm going to record this transaction and record some bills so we can see the impact on different reports. The custom field we apply to the expense transactions will only show in reports that you can customize the columns. This does not show up in standard financial statements such as your profit and loss, your balance sheet, and the statement of cash flow. When I did this offline, the custom field only appeared on the vendor's contact list report, on paid bills report, if you enter bills, and the transaction list by vendor report. I'm going to run the vendor's contact list report and customize it to show you the custom field. I'm going to run the unpaid bills report in a separate tab and customize it to show the custom field. If you don't know how to customize reports, I have done a separate video on how to do so. Click the link in the description box to watch the video or click the info card at the top. I'm going to do the same thing for the transaction list by vendor reports. The transaction list by vendor report will be the option to use in addition to your standard financial statements to give your committees or management team that extra details to understand what makes up the legal and professional service total amounts on your profit and loss statement. If you want to see custom fields for vendors apply to more reports, including the financial statement, I recommend clicking the gear icon and submitting feedback to Intuit so that they know this is something you want to see. So this is one way to use custom fields to track additional information and segment your vendors without making your charts of accounts excessively long and complicated. Let me know in the comments what other ways your organization is using custom fields, or what QuickBooks Online topic do you want me to cover next. Stick around to watch the next video and don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified when I post new videos.